welcome. You're watching Political Bazaar on Money Control. I'm Sakshi Batra, and with me is Viju Cherian. He's the opinion editor at Money Control, and we are going to be discussing about the upcoming Delhi elections. The dates have been announced. Thanks a lot, Viju, for joining in.
Thank you, Sakshi.
Well, the battle for Delhi has kicked off with the announcements of the dates. February 8 is when Delhi goes to polls,
yes.
And February 11 is when we will get the verdict for the new government. But who will form the government is the big question
now.
Yes. So I want to start off by asking you about the ruling state government, that is Aam Aadmi Party.
Uh-huh.
Do you think Aam Aadmi Party has in it to recreate the magic of 2015 that it did for itself?
Thank you, Sakshi, for actually having me on this one. It's interesting. Yesterday, the Election Commission announced the dates, and we have a month and a day from now for the polls to happen. Now, whether Aam Aadmi Party will recreate the magic or not, just a small Aam Aadmi Party thinks it can repeat the magic. That's
okay.
Because yesterday, another media organization put out a opinion poll, which gave it about 56 seats of the 70, and which the Aam Aadmi Party has said that these are all fudged numbers. These are not the real sentiments.
Okay.
They are going to repeat, or at least going to be there again, which means they're going to do it. 67 is what they got last time, and they're going to do better. That's what the Aam Aadmi Party thinks. But if you look at electoral politics over the years, what happened in 2015 is in many ways, you know, can be termed as a one-off one because of the 70 seats, 67.
Yeah.
5 years you have a rule, so now you have a record to actually show the people, and the same record also says where you have gone down.
Yeah.
So I'm not sure about it, but at the moment it looks like, you know, too early to say. But Aam Aadmi Party seems to be comfortable.
And what about the BJP? Do you think it will be able to break the jinx of the 22 years that it has not had any chance in the Delhi government, especially because of the kind of backdrop that this election really comes onto? Because you see the anti-CAA protests happening, pro-CAA protests happening, all this happening, and there have been many, many issues, and also other state assembly elections where BJP has not had a very good performance.
That's a good you know, point to bring out. In 2019, we saw the BJP coming back to power with a more thumping majority than what it got in 2014.
Yeah.
In 2014, it became the first party in a few decades to actually be the single largest party and to cross the halfway mark.
Yes.
But the very next year, in 2015, is when Aam Aadmi Party won Delhi.
That's true.
Elections. Now, again, 2019, the Narendra Modi-led government has bettered its tally than 2014, and now you have the Delhi elections coming. Can the BJP actually do it? There are certain problematic areas in the state unit in the BJP, because there seems to be a leadership issue there at the moment, at least, because they're not announcing who is the CM face at the, you know, for now they have not announced it. But if you look at certain numbers, I think there is reason to actually for the BJP to feel optimistic about it, and
okay.
that is in 2014, but these are the Lok Sabha elections.
Yeah.
In 2014, the BJP had about 46% of the votes. In 2019, that increased by 10%.
Right.
So if you look at that, yes, the BJP has been gaining ground over there in it. And of course, in 2015, it had about 32% of the vote share.
Okay.
So if you look at it, really, the vote difference over here is a bit about 10 to 14%.
Yeah.
Now, how it will capture that gap is what is important. The BJP definitely is going to, it's in power at the center. It has a whole, battery of leaders, star campaigners who are going to be there.
Yeah.
So expect the BJP to go on front foot.
Absolutely. Let's also ask about the third major opposition party right now over here, and that is the Congress party.
Okay.
So what are the chances that Congress has over here? Will it be able to finally make a comeback?
If you ask me, the same numbers, from 2014 to 2019, if you see, the Congress's voting percentage has also slightly increased.
Right.
And both the BJP and Congress have increased their voting percentage at the cost of the Aam Aadmi Party.
Hmm.
So if you look at that, I'm not sure. Again, the Congress at the local level and at the national level have a certain leadership issues.
Mm-hmm.
So how well they will be able to tackle that is a question at the moment. But if they can actually do it, they can win a few seats, I'm presuming. but not a major one to come back to power at the moment, at least, looks very unlikely for the Congress.
Absolutely. Now, we've also seen right after the announcement of these election dates yesterday by the Election Commission, we saw the Aam Aadmi Party leaders come out and say that, you know, Delhi people are going to be voting for the work that they have done in these last 5 years. So could you expound upon what kind of work have we already seen from their stable?
The Aam Aadmi Party, right from the time it came to power, has been focusing on two issues which it has projected all throughout. One is education and the other is healthcare.
Right.
And on those two fronts, the Aam Aadmi Party claims to have delivered. And yes, it has Mohalla clinics all around. That has been its pet project of sorts. Education under Manish Sisodia has, you know, it's done way better in the, you know, years that the Aam Aadmi Party has been in power.
Yeah.
So yes, it has things on the report card to actually show. But there are also places where it has not performed. For example, one of the biggest problems in Delhi, the NCR, NCT region, is that pollution.
Yeah.
Air pollution. The government, the Aam Aadmi Party government, has not really been able to tackle that. But there are also other extraneous issues, because pollution is not only Delhi-centric, it comes from other states.
Yeah.
But if you look at it, the government has not been able to deliver on that.
Absolutely. I'll also ask you to expound upon what are the other key issues that you think the people of Delhi will be voting
One thing before, you know, the voting is that the day the voting is, it's a bit interesting because it's on February 8th, which is a Saturday.
Yeah.
And Delhi, if you look at it, weekends, you know, they try to get away from it. Winter chances are less. But the point is that over the years, in 2008, Delhi voted for about 56% of Delhi voted. In 2013, it was 66%. And 2015, it was 67. And both the times, 2013 and 15, it favored the Aam Aadmi Party government. So the larger the voter turnout, it could be interpreted that this could favor the Aam Aadmi Party. Now, what are the issues that will be fought? All these issues that are there. Now, the BJP government definitely is at power in the center. So they are going to actually project the work the Modi government has done.
And as nationalism.
Nationalism will be there. Then, of course, the CA issue is there.
Yeah.
But local issues might take precedence because if you have seen in the past, you know, state assembly elections, local issues are the ones which are discussed more.
Right. And do you think these anti-CAA protests, we've also seen violence across campuses in NCR. Do you think that that will have a bearing on these polls?
I would think they will have one, because two things. One, the CAA protests have been going on for a few weeks now.
Yeah.
And definitely that is in the back of the mind of every voter. So whether either way, you know, clarity on that is required. So the BJP will go to say that it's a good thing and clarify on that. And the other parties, the opposition parties, will talk about how it is not the stand that they're actually taking. The other issue is, as you said, violence on campus. Yes. One earlier we had the violence in Jamia, and then 2 days back in JNU. These definitely will have an impact, but not a very big one, because if you look at it, the larger population in these universities are students from outside Delhi. So, but as an educational institution which has faced this kind of violence, yes, it will be a talking point, but not a major one.
All right. Thanks a lot then, Viju, for sharing all these insights with us. Well, 8th February is when Delhi will go to polls. The verdict will be out on February 11. And in between, there'll be a lot of developments that we will keep you posted on Money Control. So stay with us. Thanks a lot for watching.